Hi, this is Pastor Dan Schultz from Zion Lutheran Church. I'm so glad that you can join me today for another devotion. Today is Tuesday. No, it's Thursday. Thursday, September 10th already. And today I've got a devotion. I chose another one from Rick Warren. I thought what he had to say today was hopefully especially enlightening for us. He calls this, Focus on What Will Last Forever. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 18 says, Things that are seen don't last forever, but things that are not seen are eternal. That's why we keep our minds on the things that cannot be seen. Rick goes on to tell us that human beings can handle enormous amounts of frustration, delay, and pain as long as they have hope. But when hope is gone, people give up. Jesus offers us the only hope that's eternal, and it is a hope that will never disappoint. But you need just the right perspective to understand the hope found in Jesus. That means you don't just look at what's going on right now, today. Instead of focusing on the temporary, we need to focus on the eternal. For instance, we need to pay more attention to God's word than the news on your smartphone or TV. Difficulties don't last, but hope in God lasts forever. Another verse from Corinthians, this time from 1 Corinthians, Chapter 13, verse 13 says this, These three things continue forever, faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of these is love. Rick says that he has a plaque engraved with Hebrew letters that hangs on the wall in his office. And people ask him all the time what the Hebrew means. It simply means, this too shall pass. Says he likes to look at it when he's going through a difficult time. It reminds him that no matter what his circumstances are, they are only temporary. No problem comes and then stays in your life forever. It will pass, even if it's a lifelong chronic problem. You won't take it into eternity. Paul reminds us of this in 2 Corinthians 4:18. Read again, Paul says, Things that are seen don't last forever, but things that are not seen are eternal. That's why we keep our minds on the things that cannot be seen. So friends, I just want to share with you that your problems won't last forever. The coronavirus pandemic won't last forever. Uncertainty with the economy won't last forever. And those aches and pains that you might have, pain in my back that I have, even though it seems like it's gone on forever and will last forever, it will not. It'll only be temporary. This life is only temporary. But there are things in God's universe that you can see that will last forever. He says faith, hope, and love will last forever. And if you trust in Jesus, you will be with God forever in eternity. We have that hope as Christians. So Rick concludes his lesson today, his devotion today, by saying, put your hope in Jesus. And then Colossians chapter 3, verse 2, the Message paraphrase of that verse says this, Don't shuffle along, eyes to the ground, absorbed with the things right in front of you. Look up. And be alert to what is going on around Christ. That's where the action is. See things from His perspective. Your hope in Christ will become a hope fulfilled. And friends, I hope that's an encouragement to you if you're going through something right now that just seems like it's never going to end. Maybe something that you've been dealing with a long time. It may be some brand new development in your life. But no matter what it is, friends, you can know that it won't last forever. Faith, hope, and love are the only enduring things, and they will last into eternity. Sometimes our lives may seem like an eternity when things aren't going right, but focus on Jesus. Open the Bible. Open up to 1 Corinthians, 2 Corinthians, the passages from Colossians and Ephesians and Philippians, especially the ones that are encouraging, and see how Paul encourages those churches and those people. I look forward to being able to see you all soon, those of you who I haven't seen, especially for some time. I hope that you're all doing well. Feel free to reach out to me anytime. You can get a hold of my office number, the church's number, on our website. You can find ways to connect with me, and I hope you do so. I look forward to chatting with you. God bless.